Cox here from Wolverhampton Music Service, and welcome to Singing in the Halls 2024. Yes, these videos, these brand new videos, are to help you learn some amazing songs that you'll perform with me and an awesome live band at the Halls Wolverhampton. Now, you may have seen me before on various YouTube videos in your school, and that was for a concert called Singing in the Rain. So Singing in the Rain, we've worked on for 8 years, and that was in the town centre by the Man on the Horse, a famous statue. This year is a little bit different. That's right, we've gone next level, because we're inviting all the schools to join us at an amazing live music venue called The Halls in Wolverhampton Town Centre. There will be thousands of young people there, all singing their socks off and feeling ace. I can't wait for you guys to get together with me and the band and get singing. So I'll be sending you videos where you can sing along with me performing each song. There'll be lyrics on the track as well, so you can read along, but I'll also send you lyric sheets and backing tracks with me singing, and also a backing track without me singing. So it's all you guys. I'm also going to send you a worksheet with a few questions to make sure you're listening and watching carefully. Now, what I will say is, at this concert, there's going to be lots of different pupils from different year groups. So have a go at every song and just try your best. It's absolutely fine if you're struggling with one song, or maybe you've learned and smashed a different song. That's cool. You can come along and sing a chorus or a verse or the whole thing. Just try your best and enjoy singing with a smile on your face. At the end of each video, I'm also including a bit of CPD for your teachers. So teachers, keep watching, and you'll get a few tips at the end about how to deliver and work with these videos the best way for your pupils. So I hope you're super excited. Hope you're feeling good. And let's do this, people. Let's sing. Let's go. Hey, guys. Today's video is by one of the greatest bands of all time. In fact, they're my favourite band of all time. It's a band called The Beatles, and the song is called With a Little Help from My Friends. Now, as you know, usually I'd chat about the artist and show you some footage, maybe them singing some songs, but unfortunately, in this video, I can't, and that's because of copyright. Copyright, especially now as we live in a world of social media and YouTube, is something you may have heard of. What it means is that if I write a song and then release that song, you can't reproduce that song without my permission. That's why I always tell young people like you guys to make your own songs, create your own videos, tell your own stories, do your own artwork, because then you own them. They are your creations and you can do what you like with them. The Beatles are so famous, and I'm sure if I could give them a call and ask nicely, they'd say, yeah, sure, Paul, use a song for the video. But it's not as easy, that is it? As I say, the copyright protects the Beatles' original versions of their songs. That's why I can't show you any of the Beatles' actual music on this video. But in my videos for Singing in the Halls, I do interpretations. So it's me doing a version of the song. I'm not copying it exactly. I'm not saying that I'm a Beatle. I'm just showing you a version of that song, in case you wondered. So instead of me showing you the videos, why not take some time now in class or at home to have a look at the Beatles in action. Check them out. So I get asked this quite a lot, especially by young people. Why are the Beatles so famous for? And it's a good question. I kind of think that young people won't appreciate the Beatles until they're a little bit older. But you may have heard of someone called Elvis. Now, Elvis was pretty much the first pop star. So the Beatles were pretty much the first pop band. That means a band or an act like Elvis that had worldwide fame and worldwide appeal. It also helped that they're really, really talented musicians and singers, and they wrote some absolutely amazing songs. The Beatles were famous in the 1960s. And in the 60s, it was a time of a revolution of change, of innovation, of upheaval in business, in politics. And in fact, that innovation is still happening right now in 2024. The Beatles were the first band to revolutionise what people thought about music or pop stars, what pop stars could do. They were more famous, more well-liked, more well-known than anybody else on the planet. If the Beatles had an opinion on something, or liked or disliked something, or wore something, or changed their hairstyles, everybody would listen and copy. I think these days, pop stars like Taylor Swift, maybe Beyonce, Ed Sheeran, Adele, these are pop stars that are trying to be as big as the Beatles once were. When Taylor Swift, for example, releases a concert, I saw recently, it was on Disney Plus. And when she wears something or changes her hair or goes out with somebody new, the papers, the media, it's everywhere. But imagine in the 1960s, there was no social media, there was no internet, there was no YouTube. It was a very different time, and the Beatles encompassed, that means sums up that era. If you look at the photos in the 1960s, you can see the Beatles grew up and changed and influenced so many things, like fashion, like social trends. They were real life TikTok stars before TikTok. As I said earlier, guys, it also helped that they were really, really talented musicians, and they wrote some of the most iconic pieces of music of all time. Again, sometimes young people don't really know much Beatles music, but I really recommend you have a listen to tracks like All You Need Is Love, Hey Jude, and by the way, that was last year's Singing in the Rain song. A song called She Loves You, pretty catchy. Let It Be, Eleanor Rigby, Yesterday. I could literally tell you 100 songs to listen to, but I think it's up to you to explore and find out a bit more about the Beatles, because they offer so many different things musically. It's amazing, and that's why they're so well loved. So on to today's track called With a Little Help from My Friends. The song was released in 1967 and comes from a really iconic album called Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Now, don't get confused here, okay? It's still the Beatles, but for this album, they pretended to be another band. That's what's called a concept album. Now, these days, you may remember, or you might have heard of someone called Eminem. So when Eminem came out, he called himself Slim Shady. That was like a nickname. Someone like Lady Gaga. Now, Lady Gaga, one day you can see her playing piano, looking pretty normal, and the next day she's wearing like a crazy silver futuristic robot suit or something crazy, and she changes her style loads all the time. So the Beatles were really the first band to come up with like an alter ego, a bit like superheroes. The album cover of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band remains one of the most iconic and recognised of all time. If we take a look, it shows the Beatles dressed up as their alter ego, Sgt. Pepper's band, surrounded by their influences, famous people from around the time that inspired them. Now, you won't know many of the people on the album, and to be honest, even I don't know that many people on the album because I'm a bit too young. But all these people you can see are famous, real people, famous actors, famous sports people, politicians, musicians, and all of these people influenced the Beatles into who they are, who they were, and the kind of music they created. I guess it'd be the same as you guys making an album today, and on your album cover you had Taylor Swift, Ronaldo, Mr. Beast, Donald Trump. It's people who were really famous at the time. So imagine if that actually happened, and in 60 years' time, as a bunch of school children looking at the photo saying, who's this Ronaldo guy? The Beatles were a four-piece. That means they had four band members. Paul, John, George and Ringo. So Paul McCartney, John Lennon, George Harrison and Ringo Starr. And for this song, with a little help from my friends, it's actually the drummer who sings on it. Now you may have heard of another Beatles song which also features the drummer singing. And do you want to guess what it's called? Any ideas? Yep, it's called Yellow Submarine. If you don't know what song I'm talking about, it sounds like...
We all live in a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine. We all live in a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine.
But you can probably find that song on YouTube somewhere. It's a bit of a silly song, but it's got a real, really catchy chorus. And you can't help but sing along to it. We all live in a yellow submarine. So today's song is all about working things out, getting through life, working with your friends. And we all know how important friends are when we feel happy or sad, or we face a challenge at school or even at home. Our friends are there for us to share in the good times and the bad times. Now, talking of friends, I'd like to introduce you to a good friend of mine called Rebecca. And the reason I'd like you to meet Rebecca is that she teaches sign language. I'm super excited to tell you that the next few videos, including this one, Rebecca will be teaching you how to sign along to this song. How cool is that? If you're not sure what sign language is, it's a form of communication that uses signs, what we call gestures, for people who can't hear as well as we can. You may have seen some TV shows like CBeebies, where in the picture, in the corner, someone's signing along. At the concert, there'll be some children who use sign language in their everyday lives. And we thought how cool it would be if we could all sign together and learn this new skill. Let's say a big hello to Rebecca.
Thank you, Paul, and a massive hello to you guys. As Paul said, my name is Rebecca, and I am a sign language performer, which means that I stand on the side of the stage providing a sign language performance for concerts, music, for theatre, and all kinds of performance. And this year, I will be joining you for Singing in the Halls. I'm super excited that you're also going to be joining me to sign two of the songs using British Sign Language. British Sign Language, or BSL, is a visual form of communication which uses lots of facial expression. So make sure you have your big cheesy smiles with you. And because we're using a different language, some of the signs may be a bit higgledy-piggledy to the way we speak them or sing them. So they're going to be in a different order, but I've made sure they match the song and we can keep up with the music, and I'm sure we can help each other out as we perform. I'm going to hand back over to Paul now, but I'll be back very soon to teach you how to sign, a little help with our friends, and one love. See you soon.
Thanks, Rebecca. You'll be meeting Rebecca very soon as she joins me and the band on stage at the Halls, Wolverhampton. So now you're going to see me performing the song with a little help from my friends. And then straight after, you can see Rebecca teaching you and me the sign language. So loads of really cool things to learn and watch and get involved with. Hope you're ready. Hope you're steady. Let's go, guys. Let's go. Let's go.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with the help of my friends. Yeah, I get by with the help of my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try. What to what do when my love is away? Does it worry you to be alone? How do I feel by the end of the day? Are you sad because you're on your own? No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. Would you believe love at first sight? Yes, I'm certain that it happens all the time. What do you see when you turn out the light? I can't tell you, but I know it's mine. No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends.
Amazing. So now you know how to sing the song using your lovely voices. But now we're going to learn how to sign it using our hands, using British Sign Language. With a little help from my friends, starts with, what would you do if I sang out of tune? So you do what if I sang? These are the musical notes coming out of your mouth as you sing. So if I sang out of tune. So everything bad in sign language is shown with our little finger. Everything is good is shown with our thumb. So if I sang out of tune, would you stand up and walk out on me? So this is you and me together like this, and you walk out, so you leave me. So would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. So lend me your ears, listen to me. Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. So lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. Try not to sing out of key. I'll try using a little hook on your right hand. I'll try bouncing off your right cheek. So I'll try not to sing out of key. So we're going to try and sing perfectly like this. Then we go on to our chorus, which is I get by with a little help from my friends. So I get by. So we're going to use our middle finger here and bounce it off our chest. So I get by. And this is all of the things happening in life. You're moving through life. So I get by with a little help. So we're going to place our friend to the right of us by our side. So with a little help from my friends. And this is the sign for help, using your flat hand and your thumb on top, which is going to come from our friends over here to us. With a little help from my friends. And the next line, yeah, I get by with a little help from my friends. And the last line of the chorus is, I'm gonna try, so nod our head with the sign try again. I'm gonna try with a little, so with how? How are we gonna do that? So using both your hands interlocking together, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Well done. Now on to verse 2. What do I do when my love is away? So me do what? What do I do when my love is away? So love, and then it vanishes away into a little puppet shape like this. So what do I do when my love is away? Does it worry you to be alone? Are you worried you're alone? So are you pointing to you and then worried? So all the thoughts going around your head, worried that you're alone. And this is a tricky sign. So we have our left hand out in front of us like this, and our right hand is going to be the person coming out from underneath and then out. And next is, how do I feel at the end of the day? So pointing to yourself, I feel, using your two middle fingers going up your chest like this. So how do I feel at the, using interlocking fingers on both your hands, at the end of the day? So when the sun sets, when it's nighttime, here's your sun with your right hand, and then it's coming down below the horizon. At the end of the day, are you sad because you're on your own? Are you sad? So using your flat hand like this, going down on your face. Are you sad because, using your thumb and your first finger on your chest like this. So are you sad because you're on your own? And then on to the chorus, which we know already. And then after that chorus is the bridge, which is slightly different to the rest of the song. And it starts, do you need anybody? This is a question, so we're going to scrunch up our face like this, like we're asking a question. So do you need, do you need anybody? You, and then a flat hand down your chest. Do you need anybody? And then we're going to answer that by changing our face. I need somebody to love. So I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. And then we go on to our final verse, which is, would you believe in love at first sight? So we're going to start with believe. So thinking it's true. Would you believe in love at first? We're going to flick our finger around like this. First sight. Then this is another person coming to meet this person. First sight. Yes, I'm certain it happens all the time. What do you see when I turn out the light? So we're going to start with our lights like this, coming from the ceiling. We're going to turn them off. What do you see when I turn out the light? I don't know. I can't tell you, but I know it's mine. So we're going to point to it or the feelings, whatever's there in the darkness. I know it's mine. And a fist is flat on your chest like that. I know it's mine. And that's all the signs we need to know for this song, because the outro is just the chorus and the bridge again, which we know already. So now you can join me to sign along with the music in the background. Are you ready?
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with the help of my friends. Yeah, I get by with the help of my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try. Do I do when my love is away? Does it worry you to be alone? How How do I feel by the end of the day? Are you sad because you're on your own? No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. Would you believe in a love? Yes, I'm certain that it happens all the time. What do you see when you turn out the light? I can't tell you, but I know it's mine. No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends.
I hope you've had fun signing with me, and I'm really looking forward to performing with you in the halls very soon. Bye for now.
Hey teachers, how's it going? Here's your CPD for With a Little Help from My Friends. It's a great song, it's a lovely Beatles song. It's melodic, lyrically, it's gorgeous. The melody's not too tricky. So there's loads and loads of, I think, really cool things to get from this song. As always, I'm gonna throw lots of ideas at you. You can do your will with them. Hopefully you enjoy some of these creative tips. So obviously, let's crack on with the song straight away. As always, have a jolly good listen to it. Obviously, you've got the signing parts to this as well, which are really cool. And again, just adds so much more educational value to what we're trying to do here. Again, don't panic, don't stress. Just learn what you can. If you're working with younger key stages, perhaps just learn the chorus. And then we've got the get by and the help and the friends and so on. So there's loads and loads of different different variations you could do. If you've got some year sixes, why not try and blast the whole song through? Why not give them a challenge? Again, as I keep saying in our resource packs, I really recommend your young people try this at home. Really carry on the learning. Friends, family, get everyone involved. Could you learn it as a whole school assembly? I don't know. But again, lots and lots of things to get your teeth into and your voices wrapped around. So onto the song. So let's crack on with the song. We're going to start off with that grand opening, C to a D to an E. So again, that could be sung. You could play instruments. Got a nice little thing there, C, D, E, or even go the E, F sharp, G sharp. Little tip there for you. Again, don't worry if some of this makes no sense at all. Often I'll say things here that perhaps if you're the music coordinator, you can pick up on and you can use and you can try. Again, you might have two row glockenspiels where we can get some sharps involved. If not, just try if you've got the one row glockenspiel or even chime bars. The chorus is D, A, and E. You know. If I will help from my friends, D-A-E there. So that's a little, you could try that one if you wanted. So you could play along those notes. You can go da, 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 or da, da, da for the harmony. The melody is really nice for the start, off the E. So to, and again, a little idea could be, look at the lyrics. They're so melodic, they're so beautiful. What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song and I'll try not to sing out of key. Is there a better opening to, you know, two lyrical, two lyrical parts there? I don't know. It's genius. It's simple, but it's so effective. You get the idea that Paul McCartney is literally saying, he's telling you the story. I think that's probably one of the greatest four lines I've ever heard, you know, in music, because it just, to me, it takes you, the listener, bang, you're there. I'm sitting with Paul McCartney. He's telling me, Paul, me, have a listen to this. I'm going to sing you a little song for a second. Can I borrow your ears? Yeah, I'll try and get it right. It just sells a song instantly. And that is absolute genius. The chorus, as you probably can hear on the record, I've laid it up. So if you've got, you know, non-singers or reluctant singers, you could just literally sing, you know, buy a little help for my friend. You can buy a little help. You can kind of almost get the boys to put their arms, you know, chant away. Buy a little help for my friends. Buy a little help for my friend. It's not that difficult notation-wise. Da 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 da. Buy a little help for my friends. Obviously, I do add on a higher layer there because that's quite low. Still in D, so naturally that key, that, you know, that kind of range of the C to the middle C. That's where our vocals are sitting around for primary school children. But it's not too low. It's just, you know, you've got the low one there. You got the buy a little help for my friends. High for me, not high for your young people. So buy a little help for my friends. You can put layers on there. You can go really high. Buy a little help for my friends. So it's been a long day. Buy a little help for my friends. So the chorus melody technically is, get by with a little help for my friends. So the chorus melody roughly is, so you can sing that one, or buy a little help for my friends. You can put an extra light note in there. Buy a little help for my friends. So loads to play around that scale of E major. So if you do want to have a little jam around, you could jam on the E major scale. Go that. You got some keyboards in the class. Have a little go. But yeah, you've got a nice bridge. The bridge goes to a C sharp minor F sharp. These are difficult, tricky chords. But let me show you how it sounds for that bridge. Do you need anybody? Do you need anybody? I want somebody to love. Could it be anybody? Do, 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 do. Nice harmony there. That's the harmony. Ba, 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 ba. Ba, 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 ba. Hope that helps over the notes there. But yeah, it's a really, really fun song. The chorus is very, very layered. It's got all kinds of voices, highs and lows and mediums. You know, even if you get the kind of the wrong, oh, I'll get by, or no, or yeah, as long as we hit the bow a little help from my friend, you can do it one, you can do single notes. Bow a little help from my friends. Bow, make it as easy as you want or as difficult as you want. It's up to you. But just keep you know, going through it all and rock and rolling through that chorus, and it'll sound really cool. I think it's going to sound really powerful. Keep looking at the signing. Again, look at some other Beatles songs if you can. On the worksheet, I've got lots of references to Beatles tracks and loads to do and see. So I hope you enjoy. Have a sing with your friends. Let me know if you get how you get on and any questions or queries. Drop us an email and I'll catch you real soon. Thanks.